Hello viewers, welcome to TSAT teacher training program. Today we are going to discuss the use of authentic materials in English language teaching. You all know very well that English language is gaining a lot of importance in the present context. It is an international language. English language has become so popular in the world because of so many reasons. We all know, whether we agree or disagree, it has become a global language due to several reasons. And nowadays, it is used in various fields of life. English is also called the language of opportunities. It is a language of library. It is a window on the world. It is also a lingua franca of the languages. We all know in India there are more than 1600 languages. English is the one language which connects, which links all the languages in the world. It is the language of internets. It is the language of communication, and above all, it is used in various fields, fields like medicine, science and technology, internets, etc., etc. So, that is the reason we are very much conscious about teaching English language. Nowadays, gaining proficiency in this language is given utmost importance in our lives. So, what we are trying to do is, we are trying to teach this language. There have been several experiments in teaching of this language. There are various methods that we have adopted so far. And abundance of material is available in order to teach this language. So, nowadays, development of suitable material in an English classroom is very, very important. So, in this context, today we are going to have discussion on the use of authentic materials. We all know very well, authentic material is easily available everywhere around us. Now, let us take a look at this. In this session, we are going to discuss the meaning of authentic material, the list of authentic materials, various authentic materials are available around us, and what are the advantages of authentic materials, and also what are the problems that we generally come across while using authentic materials, and what sort of solutions we can show or we can find in using the authentic materials. Then, at the same time, how can we apply or how can we adopt this authentic material in the English language classroom, and what sort of precautions are to be taken while selecting the authentic material. So, these are the some of the things that we are going to discuss today. So, before that, let me take you forward by having some discussion on the what is the concept called authentic material. So, various persons have given various definitions to the authentic material. First of all, let us look at the definition which is displayed on the screen. According to Noonan, authentic material is any material which has not been specifically produced for the purpose of language teaching. And this is easily differentiates from course book material, For example, newspapers, magazines, articles, reviews, reports, etc. So, according to Noonan, this authentic material is not published for classroom purpose or for teaching and learning purpose. It is produced for some other purposes. And authentic material is something that is real or genuine, or it is also called real life material. Then let us take a look at one more definition given by Hammer. In his famous book, The Practice of English Language Teaching, he rightly says that authentic material or authentic texts are real texts designed not for language students, but for the speakers of the language in question. It is meant for native speakers. So, when you look at this definition, we can easily understand that it is published for the native speakers of the language. And this text is also called the real or genuine material or real text. They are not designed or they are not meant for the students in the classroom. So, it is printed, published for some other purposes, but we use it as it is in the classroom in order to give a real life experience for the children. And it is also meant to expose our children to the real life conditions. The children will know the real use of language in their day to day life. The same way, authentic materials have real language. Authentic materials are real languages. At the same time, these materials are effective and easily available. They are available at low cost or no cost. So, we can easily understand newspapers, brochures, then magazines, various varieties of materials are available everywhere. In fact, there is a plenty of language around us. So, English is around us. English is existed in the form of various materials which are produced for some other purposes. But we can adopt them to teach English language in our classrooms. That is why they are available very easily, and we need not spend much money for that, or we can say they are available at low cost or no cost. So, now let us just take a look at this picture. These are all precisely some of the materials available around us. We can see magazines, newspapers, official publications, blogs, receipts, directories, Wikipedia, then we can short stories, then product labels, novels, then menus, manuals, maps, advertisements, and all these things will come under the authentic materials. Now, let just take a look at the picture shown on the screen. These are all the different magazines, newspapers which are available in our day-to-day life. Of course, we buy newspapers and magazines for some other purposes, and how effectively we can use them in our classroom is very, very important. And now, in fact, if I want to take this discussion forward, I just would like to mention one more term, that is non-authentic materials. These materials can be, classroom materials can be divided into two. They are authentic material and non-authentic material. And what is a non-authentic material? Non-authentic materials are teaching materials which are made and designed for teaching purposes only. These materials are planned, designed, and produced based on the curriculum and policy in each country. These materials are usually in the form of textbooks. So, this is very, very clear. So, non-authentic materials, or in other words, in simple terms, we can call them textbooks or course materials. Every class has its own textbooks, which are planned and designed and written by experts, subject experts, and published by the governments, and also they are supplied to each and every school. So, that is why these books are prepared, are designed and produced according to certain guidelines or national guidelines. For example, in our state, in Telangana, we have produced textbooks according to the national guidelines or NCF document. So, but these textbooks have certain distinct qualities. They have a specific purpose, and this material is totally according to certain policy decisions, and these are meant to achieve certain national objectives. But whereas authentic material is something different, and in this discussion I don't want to say which material is good and which material is bad. That is not my intention. Every material has its own purpose, has its own advantages. At the same time, there are certain drawbacks in each and every material also. So, now let us look at this non-authentic material. Of course, you are very much familiar with these textbooks, the textbooks, English textbooks that we have adopted in our state of Andhra Pradesh. They are textbooks of 3rd class, 4th class, 5th class, class 1 to class 10, we have a set of textbooks, and these textbooks are graded. The course material is very, very carefully graded according to the guidelines of the national curriculum framework and the state curriculum framework. And this material again is graded or prepared according to the academic standards given by the NCF. So, authentic materials have their own purpose. At the same time, just I would like to draw your attention to some of the problems related to these textbooks. Suppose if you take a look at these sentences which are there on the screen. For example, there is a dialogue between two persons, Ravi and Rani. Ravi says, "How long have you been collecting stamps?" Rani, "I have been collecting them since 2001. Then Ravi says, "How many stamps have you collected?" Rani, "I have collected more than 400. Ravi, "Are there any foreign stamps among them?" Rani, "Yes, there are some." Suppose if you look at these sentences or the conversation between the two persons, we can easily say that this is an extract from a textbook. In other words, it is a bookish language, a textbook language. The problem with this type of sentence is that this type of sentences we cannot use in our day-to-day life. It means there is a clear-cut difference between the textbook language and the real-life language. In other words, the language which we use in our classroom is different from the language that we use outside. Generally, in our day-to-day conversation, we never use in full sentences, answers or questions in full sentences. For example, how long have you been collecting stamps? Nobody will say in full sentence, "I have been collecting them since 2001. Simply we say since 2001 like that, or otherwise for so and so years like that we say. "How many stamps have you collected?" "I have collected more than," we will say number, more than 400 stamps, or above 400 stamps like that, we'll give answers precisely. This is quite natural. It happens in our day-to-day life. But why this type of sentences are printed in a textbook? I have already told you, they have a specific purpose. Because in this context, the author of the textbook is trying to throw light on present perfect continuous tense and present perfect tense. That is why they have deliberately used these sentences. But it is quite away from the real life experiences. That is why this type of problems will be eliminated in using the authentic material. Now, just take a look at the differences between authentic material and the non-authentic material. For example, authentic material, you see, it is real, it is genuine, it is not at all, you know, printed for a special purpose. It is published. For example, a newspaper has its own purpose. It is, you know, freely available in the market. And the purpose, the persons who are working for newspapers are different, the publishers are different, they work for their own, you know, purposes. So, but non-authentic material, it is quite artificial. It is planned and designed. Deliberately it is used. The same way, authentic material is spontaneous. It comes without any, you know, planning and preparation, etc. But non-authentic material is created. It is made. It is a deliberate act of writing the material. At the same time, it is motivated. Authentic material is motivated, whereas this is static. At the same time, authentic material is produced in real life for communicative purposes, whereas non-authentic material is written by authors as a textbook for teaching purposes. So, non-authentic material is never used by the persons in real life. At the same time, this authentic material can be extensively used, can be used very, very freely, liberally in our classrooms. So, that is why authentic material has become very, very popular. As a matter of fact, in some of the schools, newspapers are used as supplementary material because of their, you know, because of the enthusiasm and interest that generates in the minds of the children. And the language used in authentic materials is also very, very potential, and it reflects the reality of lives, and it is also update, up to date. That is why children get attracted towards it. And also, it reflects the everyday happenings around us. That is why everybody shows interest in using the authentic material, they use it. So, and now, what is the purpose of authentic material? So, in this session, we are going to know some of the advantages of authentic material. In the advantages, as far as advantages are concerned, there are many advantages. First of all, authentic materials are used to give learners genuine exposure of the target language. Generally, when we talk about English language, English is our target language, but it is not our mother tongue. Generally, the language, English language that is used in a country where it is born, in a place where it is extensively used, has some sort of difference in their usage and in their purpose in day to day life. That is why the native speakers of English language use the language in a different way. That is why if you expose our children to that reality, that real life situation, then it will be very, very effective, and the children get attracted towards it very easily. At the same time, it is also used to motivate learners in learning English. So children, whenever they happen to see a material which appears in a different shape and size and different, you know, colors in different form, definitely we get motivated. Children feel little boring and dull when they happen to look at the textbooks, when they happen to read the textbooks. But they show a lot of interest in reading magazines. For example, the children happen to, read newspapers daily. Even the children who don't like English also, who likes to news in Telugu also, when an English newspaper is available for them, if it is there in front of them, if they are interested in sports, or if there is a cricket match going on, definitely they will turn a sports page and they start reading English news. It means they get, they motivate themselves to use the language, read, or try to listen to the news. If the cricket news comes or cricket commentary comes, telecast comes, they happen to sit in front of TV and watch TV, the commentary which comes in English language also, they used to listen to it. In the same way, it is to increase the learner's communicative competence. And to enable teachers to develop and design the teaching curriculum. Actually, authentic material is not only meant for children or the learners, it is also meant for the teachers. They can develop their teaching ability. They can design their own curriculum with the help of these authentic materials. Now, authentic materials also used to promote language learning more enjoyable. For example, when they happen to see see movies, or when they happen to watch news, or watch cartoons, or otherwise read newspapers, magazines, and there are various forms, applications, etc., which are available in their day-to-day life, which they deal with every day, they definitely show a lot of interest in it. So that makes learning more enjoyable to the children. And authentic material is used to make the language learning experience more meaningful and relevant. Generally, we connect the classroom to the real life situations. So that is one purpose. That is why this material is relevant for their real life, and it is meaningful. They know why they are learning it. And at the same time, authentic material also enables learners to learn about the culture of the country where the target language is spoken. We all know very well, generally when we are learning English language, generally English is spoken in Western countries, America, Canada, Australia, New Zealand, etc. So the culture which exists in those countries is totally different. So when children read newspapers or watch movies which are presented in English context, they will try to understand the culture which exists in those countries. Generally, the children, with the help of authentic material, the children get exposed to different cultures in the world. So children will be able to understand various varieties of cultures that are there in the world. So it brings a kind of sensitivity towards the other cultures and other human beings in the world. It also promotes creative teaching techniques for teachers. So by seeing variety of materials which are available around them, the teachers can adopt different techniques to make their classroom more effective and fruitful. So that is why they can get number of ideas, new ideas, creative ideas, innovative ideas to implement them in the classroom for the benefit of the children. And this authentic material can be divided into 5 types. For our convenience, we have categorized or put them under 5 headings. They are available in printed material, available in print form, they are called printed materials. And second one is auditory materials. Then we have third type, that is called visual materials, and then audio visual materials, and finally we have online materials. Then let us discuss them in detailed fashion. First of all, let us look at the printed materials. For example, we have newspapers, magazines, manuals, stories, novels, recipes, restaurant menus, ID cards or visiting cards, wrappers, pamphlets, comics, TV guides, invitation cards, timetables, calendars, applications, syrup bottles, tickets, receipts. So these are all the printed materials available around us freely without any cost. So for example, if we happen to buy a paste, so paste wrapper is available, and soaps, syrup bottles, these are all freely available. For example, application forms, whenever we go to any office, post office, go to railway station for filling a reservation form, or otherwise when we go to government offices to get various certificates, we have to fill in so many forms. And recipes, which are published in newspapers, stories, etc., etc. So all these things, nowadays pamphlets, so these are all printed material available for us. So we all know very well, for example, when we happen to buy a mobile, for example, for the first time, what happens? We forcibly read the manual in order to activate the mobile. So we read carefully every page as to how to fix the battery and how to fix the SIM cards, memory cards, etc. in the slot which is provided for it, and how to charge it, and how to open it, how to close it. So at the same time, what precautions are to be taken to preserve the mobile, and how to save it from different threats. These things, we will have user manuals, user guides for every electronic gadgets, not only for electronic gadgets, but various gadgets or various things that we buy every day. So why should we read all of them? Because out of necessity, we have to read it. Unless we read it, we cannot operate the mobile. In the same way, when we happen to buy washing machine or geyser or some other materials which we use in our day to day life, every time we refer to the manual whenever we get a doubt, or a TV, for example, when we happen to read buy a TV, we just go for the manual. In this way, these are all part of our lives. Even when we go to a doctor, when we go to doctor gives a prescription, and we carefully read the prescription as to what medicines are given, what tablets are given, how they are to be used, at what time, in what dosages, and some of them go to the extent of browsing the internet to see the medicine that is there in the tablets and all, we will see. So this is all out of necessity, we will see. At the same time, you just take a look at the screen, there is a medicine on the screen, Gelusil, for example. This can be used very, very effectively in the classroom. Of course, these can be used at different levels for teaching different levels of children. So now let us take a look at the screen once again. there is the paste wrapper, for example, meshwork paste wrapper, and it is full of literature. Many things are available on this wrapper. Okay, it speaks about many things. We'll take a look at this later. And now we have, for example, a pamphlet. There is a pamphlet of a coaching center. Then there is a traveling guide, a brochure is available, and then there is a railway ticket. So all these are available freely around us, and we can take them into the classroom and use them very, very effectively. After a little while, we will see how they can be used in the classroom. Now, audio materials. For example, we have varieties of audio materials. Radio news are there, songs are there, then phone messages are there, podcasts are there. So these things are very, very useful in our lives. And then at the same time, we have visual materials. We have posters. We have signboards. We have postcards. Then at the same time, medical prescriptions. If you see, some of them are displayed on the screen. There is a poster of Harry Potter. Of course, whenever children happen to see a hoarding or a cinema poster, they will look at many things: the actors, the name of the movie, the director, the music director, the cinematographer. Many things are printed on the poster. So the moment they happen to look at the poster, they will register all of them non-consciously, because they are interested in movies. When they want to go to the movie, they definitely want to know the details of the movie. So now online materials are also available nowadays. For example, we have webinars. Of course, the picture that is related to webinars is also displayed on the screen. You just take a look at that. Then nowadays, we are living in the era of social media. We have so many varieties of social media, like Twitter, WhatsApp, and then Facebook. There is full of literature. Many messages we get every day through WhatsApp, Facebook, Twitter. Even young children of 6-7 years of age also are using mobiles nowadays. So almost the material is available in English language. That is why English is available around us. It is there around us. So we pick language without any difficulty. It is available not only in towns and cities, but is available everywhere, even in village, remote parts of the state also, we see language around us. And we have blogs, video games, internet, YouTube. You know, YouTube, if you open YouTube, you have so many short videos which are available in the internet. Okay, nowadays internet is also available freely, and sometimes it is available freely, sometimes at low cost also it is available. So now almost every branch of knowledge is available on YouTube and also on internet. And Google, Google is also called a big guru, Google guru. So plenty of knowledge is available. Whenever I have a doubt, even now, I click onto Google and browse through it, and I get the information. So that is why the children are access to internets. Children are access to computers nowadays. They are access to mobile phones. So since all these gadgets have become very cheaper and accessible to us, we can utilize them in our classrooms. That is why nowadays I have seen so many teachers using smartphones in their classrooms in order to teach various complex things. That is why they are becoming very, very successful. Suppose, right, now audiovisual materials, you can see radio programs, TV programs, advertisements, songs, films, video tutorials. In the same way, what sort of competencies to be promoted? We can promote listening competencies, listening for gist, listening for specific information, and we can promote reading skills among the children. reading skills like skimming, scanning, organization of text, identifying topics, topic sentences in a given text, and also speaking skills. We can teach pronunciation, accent, and we can expose our children to the native speakers English language. That is generally not cannot be provided in the classroom. So that is why when we happen to play a video, short video, the children happen to see it, and automatically they can pick that accent. Then writing skills like summarizing and reporting, etc. At the same time, they can also take up creative expression in the form of, they can analyze the discourses. So, and for young children, we all try to teach handwriting, but this is a very, very useful, this type of writings which are available in posters, on labels, on different brand items. You can easily teach them how to write beautifully, without teaching them, they can develop calligraphy very, very easily. And now let us watch this video.
Stop me doing most
Please
things.
Watch this video. This video is on Stephen Hawking. So with the help of this video, we can teach plenty in the classroom.
That would kill me in 2 or 3 years. My motto is there are no boundaries.
So watch this video.
So remember to look up at the stars and not down at your feet.
Here's a guy who cannot walk, who cannot speak, who cannot move independently, and yet somehow he still found a way.
I feel a sense of achievement that I have managed to make these contributions, despite having ALS. All my life, I have sought to understand the universe and find answers to these questions.
See how effective it is when you happen to see. Actually, this video is not produced for any classroom purposes. It is a movie. It's a movie trailer, but this can be used very, very effectively in order to show the greatness of a person. Children naturally are interested in movies, so this can be exploited very, very cleverly and effectively. So short videos can be played. Generally, children watch movies, but if you bring movies which are selected carefully, definitely they can serve a wonderful purpose. So now, after showing this video, you can conduct a wonderful activity, a very, very useful activity. You can bring out their creative thinking, and you can develop their listening and speaking skills. Just take a look at the screen. So we can develop listening and speaking skills. For example, we can interact with the children by posing these questions. For example, what do you know about Stephen Hawking? And what qualities does a person require to become great? What inspiration can you draw from the life of Stephen Hawking? These questions will enable the children, motivate the children to think differently. You can promote their divergent thinking. So when you promote thinking, children will come out with the different ideas. So language can be promoted by making the children think divergently. There is one more question. Disability will never become a hurdle for anyone to become great. Suppose if you put this question for discussion or debate, I think this will become an effective, you know, activity. So in this way, it can be exploited very, very easily. And then see this wrapper on Santur, and you can show the wrapper to the children. And this is the format for an activity. We should have a thorough understanding about what should happen in the classroom. So that is why we need to know the objective of the activity, the level of the learners who are participating in it, then materials required, number of learners required, role of the learner, role of the teacher, and the process that is to be followed, or the procedure. So these are to be first the teacher has to prepare well in advance, so that he can conduct the activity very, very effectively. Suppose by showing this wrapper, the teacher can design different levels of activities. For example, for level 1 children, there should be, he can divide the information into various columns, and he can give like the serial number, colors, pictures on the wrapper, then product inside the wrapper, uses of the product. So you can give this table for the children to fill it up, or otherwise you can divide the children into groups, and each group is provided with this table, and they can discuss among themselves and do it by seeing the wrapper. Then for level 2 children, little higher children, you can again provide this table, and you can ask them to fill it up, and you can see there is a little bit of gradation in this. And for example, level 3, there is a pair work. For example, you can divide the children into various pairs and provide a wrapper, or you know, some syrup bottle or something else which contains this information: name of the soap, place of manufacturing, name of the company that manufactured, weight of the soap, price of the soap, special qualities or the date of manufacturing, expiry date if any, so are any offers are there on the product. These things are there. So one student has the wrapper with him, and other student, his partner, will pose him a number of questions. So as the other person asks questions, this person will give responses, so that you can promote a lot of listening and speaking skills among the children. So the children will know how to make questions and how to respond. So by this, they can develop the ability of reading also, and you can convert it into writing activity also. So in this way, this can be used very, very effectively in the elementary classes also. And this activity provides opportunity for developing listening and speaking and questioning skills. So then we have a newspaper clipping here, and newspapers are very, very common, and useful material can be collected from it, and a newspaper clipping is displayed. We ask the children to read it, and after reading, we can develop vocabulary activities, like by giving a matching test like this. Then we can give fill in the blanks, we can give yes or no questions like this, or true or false, and we can develop comprehension questions, and we can give a list of comprehension questions, and divide the children into groups and ask them to discuss among themselves and come out with their presentations, so that the teacher will be able to he will be able to give responses, and at the end he will give some feedback to the children, very, very positive and productive feedback to the children. So the children will understand on their own. Then grammar also can be, grammar, vocabulary, everything can be promoted, and you can conduct discussions based on the newspaper clippings. Nowadays, newspapers appear every day, so news are very, very update. The children would like to learn those things which are relevant for them in their day-to-day life, and which are very, very fresh. So they don't like to read the outdated things. So if they read the fresh things, they will show a lot of interest. At the same time, this type of wrappers can be used very effectively. And generally, you know, use of authentic material, there are certain difficulties in the use of authentic materials. For example, sometimes, you know, learners may feel difficulty with words and culture. So that is why we have to understand the level of the children very, very carefully. The culture in which this is used also must be very, very carefully selected. And the level, the chosen material may not be at the level of the children. So their age and level of understanding also should be kept in mind. So sometimes it may become an overburden for the children. That is why the teachers may not show interest. So at the same time, what are the solutions for this? First of all, there are some solutions. Definitely we can solve it. Choose the material carefully as per the age, interest of the learners, and grade the tasks. The task, just like the way we have seen a little while ago, for example, we can divide this activity into different levels according to the age and level of the children. At the same time, just watch this. There is one song, you know, songs also can be, English songs can be used very, very effectively. For example, there is a song by Michael Jackson, Earth Song, very, very famous. This is very, very famous song by Michael Jackson. Wonderful song. This is on environment. So we all talk about environment, and we should make the children sensitive towards the environment, wildlife, and how to protect environment. See, this song, it is very, very vibrant song. Children like to watch Michael Jackson. So the lyrics are in English. So when out of interest to see the dance, to see the situation, they show a lot of interest. So this can be understood very, very easily. Yes. So now we can design different activities on this. We can conduct discussions by posing varieties of questions. So what would happen to the world if we lost the forests and wildlife, and what would you do to protect the environment? What is the message of the song, the Earth Song by Michael Jackson? This way you can bring in a lot of creativity in the classroom. The classrooms can become very, very active and vibrant. And there are various websites available in our present context. So these websites also there. For example, I have come across, when I am preparing for this, I have come across one website, TWURDY, TWURDY, TWURDY. This is actually they are making